Hi guys, as you may already know, we at Multilogin routinely collect and analyze millions of browser fingerprints collected from real, regular internet users every month. And usually we analyze fingerprints that consist of different numbers and texts do not analyze so-called hardware fingerprints. But recently we decided to analyze them just in case and found some very interesting patterns. Something that is completely opposite to what most of the people in community interested in browser fingerprinting and online privacy in general tend to believe. Now, let me ask a question. Do you think that masking Canon's fingerprint is important for your privacy? Regardless of whether you answered yes or no, today we set up and recorded a bizarre, massive experiment that will just blow your mind away because it goes totally against everything that was previously believed in the community.
To make this experiment possible, what we did is we contacted local shops that specialized in selling old and new PCs. And what we did is we checked each and one of these computers and went to Browser Leaks and Panopticlick to check their canvas. We did this so you wouldn't need to do it yourselves. And what we found out is that all of these different PCs which had different hardware installed, different processor installed, these computers also had completely different builds whatsoever. And what we found out will completely blow your mind. To make this video short, we will not go through the whole testing process. Today we will see a miniaturized version of this testing. What we have here on this table are completely different computers from different brands with different graphics cards and different years of manufacturing. And we have Browser Leaks and Panopticlick open on each and one of these computers on a regular, normal Chrome browser. And how about right now, we go and take a look what is the canvas signature on these computers. Okay, let's start from this small laptop. And what we see is that we have the signature ending with 5AA. Let's go then to a second computer, which also has a signature ending with 5AA. On this Dell computer, which is completely different model, has completely different graphics card, has absolutely the same signature. And let's take a look at the three computers at the back as well. As you can see, they have the same kind of a signature, ending with 5AA. All different models, all different graphics cards, years of manufacturing, different PCs. We also have one stationary computer right here, and what you might think is definitely going to be different. Well,
it's not.
And you can take a look for yourself. Absolutely the same signature.
I'd like to add here that we went through over 100 of different computers, and we are not testing them randomly, like just everything you've got. We were only testing computers that had different operating systems, different graphic adapters, and different hardware overall. And what we found out is that the amount of those matches of Canon's fingerprint between absolutely different machines is astonishingly high. For example, we had Windows Tab PCs, which had matching canvas to all these computers. We had some mobile phones, we had like desktop computers, laptop computers, and it even went to a bizarre situation when we've been testing different laptops, and 17 times in a row we've got absolutely the same canvas on absolutely different computers.
Our conclusion is that canvas fingerprinting threat is completely overblown. Practically speaking, this means that you can do whatever you want with unmasked canvas as long as you launch the same browser profile on the same machine. Let's quickly talk at how this assumption that we need to mask canvas fingerprint came in the first place?
Where do normal users check their canvas and canvas fingerprint? It's mainly two websites. One is the most popular, is browserleaks.com, and another is less popular, is panoptically.com. And let's take a look what browserleaks.com actually is showing us. Mm-hmm. For example, on this machine where we had, which we looked at before, it shows that the uniqueness of canvas fingerprint for this machine is 99.9%, and it has 423 matches out of roughly 500,000. But what it says next, it says that 423 user agents out of 500,000 have the same signature. And what does it actually mean? Does it mean that this amount of users have the same signature? Absolutely not. We have zero information about how many users have the same signature. What we see, however, is that there are certain browsers or browser versions or browser forks with different user agents which have the same kind of signature. What information does it give to us regarding browser fingerprinting and privacy in general? Essentially, it gives us no information. It just gives us some picture about like how this fingerprint compares to other elements of a browser fingerprint, but it doesn't tell us whether it's good or bad. In fact, we tested some MacBooks from years 2012, 2013, 2014, and so on. And what we discovered is that this uniqueness parameter is very, very high on those MacBooks. In fact, it was higher than we could see here on Windows laptops. Because on MacBooks we only have got 60 to 100 matches according to browser leaks. And the same is valid for Panopticlick. Panopticlick uses a little bit different number, which is uniqueness, which also shows how much information does this fingerprint add, does canvas fingerprint add to the whole fingerprint in comparison with other elements of that fingerprint. But basically it doesn't tell you how many other users have this fingerprint. And the situation might be that this particular fingerprint, 1,000 other users have this particular fingerprint, or maybe 1 million, or maybe 1 billion, we don't know. Basically, we cannot get this type of information from browser leaks. Mm-hmm. And we think that the idea that the less unique is your canvas fingerprint, according to browser leaks or Panopticlick, the better it is, the more protected you are from being tracked by websites, stems from this misunderstanding of what browser leaks and what Panopticlick websites and checkers actually tell you. They are not meant to be used in this way, and it's completely wrong interpretation by the community of these numbers. So what I want to say in the conclusion is that you should not rely on what the checkers say, and instead you should rely either on actual stats when they get published by everyone, or for now you may rely on what we tell you.
A possible question that you may have: which hardware, which computers should I use in order to better blend in with a non-unique canvas signature? What hardwares are better, what OSs are better, and how to more successfully utilize it? We will provide this information in the second part of this video series, where we will be specifically talk about this. Now, another question is about if masking canvas is not needed, what's going to happen with natural canvas? Well, first of all, I need to point out that natural canvas is already being tested by a few of our users. It is performing quite well already. It produces really good results. It's not ready to be scaled to a point where all multilogin users are able to utilize it. So, if masking canvas is not important, then why do you, why we should even develop natural cameras? Well, there are use cases where you absolutely must mask your canvas with a non-unique one, and we will talk about this specific topic in the third part of this video series.
And for that, for today, that's it. Bye.
Yeah, thanks very much for watching. But I still think masking canvas is important.